welcome to part 7 of the G81 M3 Touring Carbonwurks project. So as you can see, the car is complete. We've done everything from the engine bay, exterior carbon work. We've done some PPF in, almost forgot that, as well as some bits on the interior and around the car. We've done everything. This car's looking fantastic. Oh yeah, suspension spacers. The list goes on. Check the other 6 parts out if you want to see it all. So what we're doing today is the protection phase. So this car obviously has come from factory. It's got next to no protection on it at all. In fact, it's awful. The water almost sticks. The paintwork's horrible. So tell us, Sam, what are you going to do today? You've got some products over there. Talk to the camera.
I'm going to go over here and show you the wide array of stuff we're going to use because I haven't been around the car enough times yet. So I'm going to go around it again with most of this. So I'll start over here. Some pre-wash stuff, snow foam, so remain contactless. That's quite standard. We've then got some matte safe shampoo and there's rapid detailer there and some wheel cleaner, which probably won't be needed because they're still brand spanking. We then come on to the polishing phase. So some of the gloss parts of this vehicle need a bit of finesse. So the roof and some of the trim, we're just going to go over lightly with a polisher. This is a finishing polish from Kosh Chemie. So that'd be that. Some polishing pads for that there. Then we're going to get into looking at the protection side of it, as Dan said, which it comes in the form of ceramic coatings. So we've got a couple here, 2 different brands. We've got this one here from Geon, which is the matte safe, as it says, you can probably see on the bottle. So that there itself is the coating, and this is a maintenance spray for later down the line. So that's going to go on the main bulk of the panels on the car, obviously with its satin matte finish paint. Then we've got what's left of some G-Technic crystal serum we've been using before, which we really like. That's going to go on the gloss parts of the car, so predominantly the roof, and some of the carbon parts will coat as well. And then lastly, should we get the time, and I feel like going around the car once again, we've got the XOV4, which is a hydrophobic coating, so that helps to extend the life of all of the ceramic coatings underneath it, and also does the stereotypical water sheeting beading process. So the bit that everyone likes to see on the video. I've missed out the panel wipe, which is in the middle here. So that's just a prep for the prior to the ceramic coat itself. So it's like an alcohol-based wipe that's going to strip off any polishes, waxes, that sort of stuff on the car before we then go ahead and put the coating on top. So yeah, I think that just about covers it. Any questions, pop them in the comments. Otherwise, we're going to give it a wash and get cracking.
Detailing phase is now all finished, so that's part 7 wrapped up. And you might notice it's still slightly dark outside. It's actually just gone 5:30 in the morning. We finished this up yesterday evening. We've left it to cure overnight, make sure that ceramic coat is nicely sealed in, nice and cured. And we're about to head off for a photo shoot with our man, Rich Pierce. So the project is complete, or at least it is for the moment. Maybe there might be a little bit of a change later on. We'll see, but follow me down the back and just take this in and absorb it. I mean, I'm really, really happy with the way this car's turned out. Obviously, this is the first we've ever done in terms of it's an M3 Touring for us, but the car looks absolutely amazing. I'm happy now that it's got its protection. You wouldn't believe how sticky the paint was, but now it's nice and smooth and the PPF is done, and that's also been ceramic coated. So we're all done and finished up here. If you've made it this far in the video, I just want to say a big thanks to you guys, the viewers. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Our channel is growing. It would be really appreciated. And a big thanks to the guys at Carbonwurks as well. Sam, who has been putting in obviously blood, sweat and beers into this car, and as well Tim, who's behind the camera there, which you rarely see. Big thanks to you guys, and we'll see you guys soon, potentially for part 8 or something else, who knows. But thanks for watching. See you guys soon.